G'day guys, Calvin, Cartoon Company from New Zealand. I've been wiring a Haltech 2500 onto a 1UZ. And I thought I'd talk a little bit about the idle speed, just very quickly. The Haltech can run this just fine. Controls it nicely, and these are actually a really awesome unit. They're quiet, they give good idle control, and they've got a wide range. They can really give it a lot of revs. But I faced a problem on this job. I had too many other outputs that were required. There's a few that you have to have. You know, it's quite important to have a fan and a fuel pump. On this particular job, I don't have to have a taco, so that's pretty simple. I have to have a speedo output. The reason I have that is it's got a cable speedo in this particular vehicle, with cable speedo cluster, and so it's got a little driver that runs that pulsed from the ECU. So I need an output for that, because we need a speedo to keep this vehicle legal. The other things I've got in this particular case is I'm running the transmission. So I've got a lot of outputs used down to that transmission. There's four of them going down there. The line pressure, the lockup, and I've used two others, the drive-by-wire from the 2500 for the two solenoids. That does mean that I'm getting a little bit short on digital outputs. So I've chosen to ditch the six-wire stepper, and I've gone to a simple two-wire solenoid, which will be really, really simple to set up. In this particular case, one side of it will get voltage and the other side gets a signal from the ECU. I've already prepped the wiring in this case, and I'm going to put, so the stepper is going to get voltage from the relay block. Been doing this all day, they've been popping in fine, and then I get to do this one and it decides it doesn't want to go in. There it goes. And then the other side is going to go to one of my stepper outputs in this case, or a digital pulsed output, DPO, on the Haltech. On different ECUs, they might call that output something different. However, it all does pretty much the same thing. The advantage of this particular two-wire stepper is it could be used on some of the lesser output or lesser spec ECUs that can't control the six-wire or a four-wire or a multi-wire stepper, and it only takes one output from the ECU. That makes it a really good option for the likes of a 550 on a budget, but you still get that idle speed control, which is really nice. Now, quick note on the idle speed. Seen some discussions recently on idle steppers not working and the suggestion of taking the stepper off and using the ECU to tune out the stepper motor or to not have an idle speed and just doing it with the ECU. To improve cold idle, I can give it a little bit more timing. Of course, well, we are going to need fuel to make it idle. It will need a higher fuel requirement. And funnily enough, it needs more air to bypass the throttle body to maintain correct idle. And it needs a lot more air the colder it gets. So you actually need a way of getting more air into the engine, which happens to be a stepper or a solenoid. So if you don't have one, you'll get a low idle when cold, if you get it to idle. And then you need often to wind the main idle up quite a lot higher than would be ideal. This vehicle is going to be an automatic. I want a low idle speed, definitely want a stepper. Most people and most times I look at things and I see guys and they simply haven't put in enough time and effort to make a proper idle circuit. Most of the professionals I know run an idle stepper of some kind to give it nice cold idle, because EFI is meant to be nice, It's not meant to be like a carburetor that needs a choke pulled out and you have to manually do all that stuff. You just turn the key on, it idles up, does everything nice, beautiful. So guys, I highly recommend keeping a stepper motor or a solenoid or some kind of idle speed control. Hope that's been helpful. Talk to you again soon. Catch you later.